श्याम मनोहर बैठे बोलत श्याम मनोहर बैठे कदम खंड और कदम की छैया कदम खंड और कदम की छैया बोलत श्याम मनोहर बैठे श्याम मनोहर बैठे बोलत श्याम मनोहर बैठे कदम खंड और कदम की छैया कदम खंड और कदम की छैया बोलत श्याम मनो बैठे बोलत श्याम
नमस्कार आई विल स्टार्ट विद अ ध्यान श्लोका इन प्रेज ऑफ लॉर्ड शिवा हु इज सेट टू बी द किंग ऑफ डांस आंगिकम भुवनम यस्य वाचिकम सर्ववांग्मयम आहार्यम चंद्र ताराधि तम नमः सात्विकम शिवम द प्रेयर मीन्स whose bodily movement is entire universe, whose speech is a language, whose ornaments are the moon and the stars. Him, we worship the pure and serene Lord Shiva. One evening when I was doing my riyas, my practice, I started observing my hands keenly and thought, how these hands can bring change in your life, how your hands can heal you, how these hands has been used for centuries for healing various ailments. In Natya Shastra, which is a shastra of performing arts, there is a shloka. Yatho hasta tatho drishti, yatho drishti tatho manaha, yatho manaha tatho bhav, yatho bhav, tatho rasah. Which means, where your hand goes, your eyes follows. Where your eyes goes, your mind follows. Where your mind goes, so follows the expression. Where your expression goes, so follows the emotion. That is ras, pure entertainment of life. So your hands can actually connect you directly to the ras. Isn't it amazing? Ras, the essence of life. But how many of us actually knows the importance of our own hands? Until a while ago, I too had a little knowledge about them. As I'm a trained Kathak dancer, I only knew that these are the great storytellers. Look, the peacocks are dancing. Tat ta thai, thai tat ta thai, tat ta thai, thai tat ta thai. Hey, where are my flowers? The eagle is flying. That's it. I knew the term yoga mudra, where people keep themselves fit by practicing hand yoga. And I also knew that in dance, specifically in classical dance, we use different hastas or mudras to communicate various events, ideas, creatures. But what I did not know was these two has the connections. I was surprised when I found that throughout my childhood, I was unknowingly practicing hand yoga. It amazed me to find that the hastas or mudras used in various classical forms of dance are very similar to hand yoga. I've been dancing ever since I remember. People have always talked for ages that if you come in contact with God, you will become blissful, you know, Brahma Anand. And I can proudly say that I stay mostly in this state of blissfulness because of my dancing. Dance is not just an exercise or an entertainment, but it is a form of spiritual practice where you can improve physical, mental, and spiritual well-being. It is very sad that these days people refer it as a mere twisting or curling your body into different shapes and postures, but it is not. It is not related to outer body. Dance does not just fit you physically, but there is this psychological healing which takes place without one's knowledge. According to an ancient Vedic wisdom, your health is literally in your hands. Why? This is because four fingers and thumb represents the five major building blocks of which the entire universe is made. Fire, air, sky, earth and water. Touching one finger with other in different combination creates circuits in our body through which energy flows. Such a flow of energy not only increases the blood circulation but also improves your concentration, observation and lot more. Coming back to dancing, according to an ancient scripture, Abhinaya Darpana, there are 28 single hand gestures and 24 double hand gestures which are used to tell any story in any language, as we, the dancers, communicate with the body, not with the voice. Hastas or mudras are used to tell stories from Indian epics and Hindu mythology. And in Hasta yoga, the thumb is considered symbolic as a cosmos and the index finger is the individual consciousness. Yoga is directed towards bringing together the individual to the cosmic consciousness. Making your body limber, strong and detoxified, we not only relax ourselves but also lower down our stress level. So fitness, when we talk about fitness, people only talk about exercising, jogging, dieting, reducing weight. But nobody pays attention to what is going inside. Are we stress-free? Are we happy? Are we relaxed? We all deal with a lot of stress these days. It is hard to clear the constant chatter of our mind. People suggest that the best way is to practice meditation. But how? how to start, where to start. So to start, I find these Hasta mudras are the best way to practice meditation. Best. So the aim of fitness is not just a physical fitness. The aim is much higher. The aim is transformational. The aim is to come out from your comfort zone and at a slightly higher level. In dance, coming back to dancing, in dance we use, as I already said, that we use different hastas to communicate story. So let's try to recollect one story right now. I hope you remember the famous story of Fable of the Lion and the Mouse. So before starting, I would like to introduce few hasta mudras and would appreciate if you do it with me, please. Shikhar. Shikhar means superior. Next is Simhamukha. Any guesses? Lion's head. Karkatam. Karkatam means net. Kartari Swastikam means to cut. Tiny creature. Mouse. Mukula. Namaskar mudra is Anjali mudra, you all know. So let's start the story. There was once a proud and superior lion who caught in the hunter's net. He tried to get out as hard as he could, but eventually gave up. A tiny mouse peered from the hollow of a tree. Lion asked for help. Tiny mouse, hesitant at first, decided to help. He cut the net from his teeth, letting the lion free. So the moral of the story is, even the strongest may need the help, right? Even we, the strongest creature on the earth, may need the help. I would like to share a few mudras which are very similar to classical dancing and yoga mudra. First one is Anjali mudra. You all know. It's a Namaskar mudra and is very common greeting gesture in India. But what is the meaning behind this gesture of bringing both the palms together and bowing down? I salute the divine self which is manifesting through you. The energy that is normally lost from the palms is conserved by close-circuiting the nerve circuits of both the palms together. It not only reduces stress, anxiety, calms your brain, but also, to your surprise, it creates the flexibility in your hand and fingers. Next is Hamsasya Hasta. Can you please do it with me? Thank you so much. Hamsasya Hasta in dancing means shape of a swan. And in yoga, it is a mudra, a gyan mudra, that is mudra of knowledge. It not only increases the memory power, concentration, but also reduces your anger. So whenever you feel angry, start practicing Hamsasya Hasta. Next, Trishul. Trishul in yoga is a Varun mudra, that is mudra of water, which balances the water content in the body and it also cures all the skin diseases. Next, Mayurakhyo. Mayurakhyo is the peacock in dancing, and in yoga it is a Prithvi mudra, that is mudra of earth. It helps in gaining weight. So all those who are here who wants to gain weight, please start practicing Mayurakhyo. It not only gains weight, but it also boosts your self-esteem and confidence. Next, Ardhapataka. Ardhapataka is half flag in dancing, and in yoga it is known as Surya Mudra, that is mudra of fire, which actually regulates the body temperature of your body, digestion, cholesterol levels. And it is said that if you practice Ardhapataka, that is the mudra of fire, at least for 20 minutes in a day, empty stomach, in a sitting position, you will lose excess fat. So those who want to lose weight, please start practicing Ardhapataka. Next, Kartari Mukha. Kartari Mukha means the scissor in dancing, and to your surprise, it increases the eye power. And while doing this, if you are very tired or drained or need extra boost of energy, you should practice Kartari Mukha. Next, Simha Mukha. We already discussed. people do Simha Mukha like this also. Simha Mukha helps in regulating diabetes, cure constipation and etc. things. Next and last, Mushti, Adi Mudra. Mushti relaxes your nervous system. It helps you in breathe deeply and it also connects you to the cosmic energy. So these were the just few mudras. There are number of mudras which not only keep you fit physically, but also keeps you healthy internally. Regular practice of certain mudras can actually cure diseases and ensures the proper flow of prana within the body. So at the end, I would like to say something. Mudras or healthy hastas are a very small aspect of Indian classical dancing. Not only that, Indian classical dances teach you our culture, improves flexibility and improves body balance, gives you grace, and more importantly, teaches you the discipline. And whenever the fitness comes, discipline comes first. Right or wrong? Right. So, guys, friends, we earn from our hands throughout our life, right? But we have forgot that these hands are our real earnings. Dance, as this is the best way to explore yourself. This is the best way to keep you fit outside and inside. And moreover, it gives you 7 different options to choose from. Bharatnatyam, Kathak, Mohiniyattam, Manipuri, Kuchipudi, Kathakkali, Odissi. So you can choose. You have options. So guys, friends, please follow our age-old culture as an alternative cool yoga. Namaskara.
Thank you, Ankita.